I'll have a nerd. So this is boss fights, easy to hardest, part two. 9 to 1. Okay, so 9 being the easiest one in this section, 1 being at the hardest. So number 9, cursed, rotted, great word. Okay, why I put this up here, it's quite high, isn't it? You know, considering it's quite close. It's because, again, the contributing factors we've got to think about to what makes these bosses, for me, hard and annoying as fuck, is one, do you die to him? Is there a chance you can die to him? That's, you know, if you keep on going, he's a hard boss, and you face him like 3 times and never die, he's not hard, is he? Or she. So, I've died to this, I think I've beat this boss about 4 times, and yes, I've died to him. The thing is as well, you think to yourself, how the fuck do you beat it? It's not easy to figure out as such. I mean, you got to go for the pussy things, haven't you? There's ones at the front, there's ones on one of the ankles, there's one on one of the wrists, there's ones at the back. In the first section, just go for the ones at the front. Because as soon as they're smashed, he goes down to another level. I mean, I'm lucky enough, before he does it, I can get that one as well. Again, I really recommend a long sword, just take them out nice and quick. You want to do that because you want to go down, because going down is easier. I mean, because you haven't got all these fuck. Those guys keep on coming otherwise. I mean, it could be a little bit harder because you've got this hand, but the hand, even though you'll see a hand come at the front now out of his pus here, even though the hand can do some good damage to you, it also enables you to hit it. So if you run out, if you think, oh, I'm struggling hitting certain parts of these sacks, you can rely on that. The way I look at it is that this guy hasn't, you know, if you want to try and be a caster, being a caster is difficult on this because it's not, it's going to be difficult to hit the bits you want. So I recommend either being a strength build or in particular just dex, slight dex at the beginning like I am now with my character, Melina, call me. And then just go at it. But he has got the potential to just, you know, fucking do some good damage to you because he's early on. And that's where he is, you know, he has got a good chance. So that's why I put him where he is. I mean, he could be easier, without a doubt, but for me, because he's quite early on, you got a good chance of dying to him, and he's a bit weird, so yeah, I'd put him at 9. Number 8, Dancer of the Boreal Valley. Some people put this person higher. Again, let's think of the fact, is he easy to get to in terms of when you unlock a bonfire without getting too much shit? Yeah, he is. I go for the Vault guy, the second one's bonfire, and just run up past the... How many knights is it? 2 knights? In order to beat him? But this is a horrible fight. I've beaten him, as I said, about 4 times, and this is by far the worst. I tried using Dark Drift for a change when I'm used to using either a heavy weapon or my long sword. This is the first one I thought, let's use this Dark Drift. And I really regret doing it. I couldn't fucking hit him. Couldn't hit the cunt. Because what you've got to do is, that's it. You've got to be a bit of a pervert and just go behind his ass. Her ass, whatever it is. Okay, when you're in that area there, she can't really get you. And she'll do all her spinny attacks. I mean, the grab attack, that seems to have got me twice. Does some good damage, and I've been very fortunate not to die. But I've never died to her. I haven't died to her in the 4 times I've played, so... That I can think of anyway, or you know, even think of getting frustrated. I never get frustrated. Again, healing is quite easy to do. She can do spinny combos, but I don't feel like as if I've ever got caught up in it to the point where, you know, she does a good amount of damage to me to finish me off. And if you watch, right, look how many of my shots are missing. I'm not doing a ridiculous amount of damage. So look at this. I misjudged this, but that should be easy to dodge. That's slow. So it hit me twice, but I didn't get caught up in it, and I was easy to get behind her ass again. It's just look how easy it is to heal again. A huge contributing factor. Can I heal easily? I've been able to heal and buff my stamina. Nice big area as well. I mean, if you put this in a smaller area, it'd be a lot more problem. She's quite slow. It's just this weapon has just made this fight look a lot harder than it is. It's a fucking easy fight. Wouldn't recommend basically using spells. Just get up close, get up by your ass, and use a short sword, use something, or a spear, something that's going to lunge forward. The moveset of this two-handed katana has just made it a lot harder than it needs to be. It's fucking shit. But the dance, it generally, I don't think, is fucking pussy fight. See you there! Hey! Nah, she's fucking shit. this is me basically just getting frustrated and be like, fuck me, I should have used the short sword. I would have made it a lot easier. See, look, you go forward. So you keep on going towards the legs. Number 7, Abyss Watchers. They're quite high again because my first playthrough, this was the first boss I started yelling at. Because it's just, it is quite hard. It is quite hard because it's relatively early on. I mean, you can, because what I did is I faced him, this one, before I did Deconsider Deep last time, whatever they're called, those skeleton guys. So I did them a little bit earlier and I wasn't as enough powered as I needed to be. So I just think that they got the potential and they got that kind of like Bloodborne feel to it where it's kind of manic, it's kind of fast, it feels fast. And if you don't know what you're doing, it can basically catch you out. The thing is, what you got to do is, to begin with, is make sure you've got a good shield with physical protection. Make sure that you've got a good fast weapon like the longsword because it will stagger. Why the shield is important is that when he tries to do a combo and uses his dagger on it, he will stagger backwards, as you've already seen in this video, which is great, isn't it? You can backstab him, again, that makes him weak. And also, when you hit him with even a short sword, it's got a good point of stagger capability. So you put all those into consideration, yeah, he's not that hard. You've got to be able to just take your time and realize that, because he's quick, he's powerful. To begin with, the fight seems like as if you're against a million of them. You're not. You'll be against two to begin with, then the third one should help you. So just basically, I suggest just dodge him for a little bit until that third one comes to help, and then beat him two on two, and then you get to this fight where it's one on one. Try and put some fire resistance on, but you know, use that shield and be aggressive, and it shouldn't be much of a problem. But I have died to him a few times. Number 6, Yudix Gundyr. This is the first boss. And again, what have you got to think to yourself is, yeah, he's easy to get to, okay? So a bonfire is quite close in order to get to him. But you can't make your character overpowered like you can with any of the other bosses. You can't do that because you could keep on farming those little guys for a little bit until you do it, but that would take you a million years. So you're limited. You can't level. Oh no, it doesn't matter, does it? You can't level up anyway. So this is, you have to beat him with what you're given. And you're still a weak ass. So I've already died to him once in this playthrough. You can see my souls there with my old Dex one. I've only got 3 Estus. I can't make you 4. I can't do anything that. It's got to be 3. Okay? I put the life ring on to make it easier. When he becomes this fucking diarrhea thing on the top, his moves are difficult to comprehend. So he's got a good chance to just beat you. He's powerful. He hits you hard. That's 2 hits and I'm almost dead. So if you don't know, if you haven't got your good roll and stuff like that, he is difficult. I suggest either doing a caster build or making sure you've got your pyromancy. But then again, in this game, the casting speed is far too slow, so he will catch you out. It's a hard boss. It's a hard boss that I've died to quite a few times because of what I've just said. Number 5, Soul of Cinder. Right, so technically, the last boss. Technically the last boss. Hey! The reason why it's quite hard, quite easy, is one, the bonfire, you've got it right there, you run to it, no enemies, so you're guaranteed to get there with your full Estus. So take that into consideration. The reason why he's hard, his movesets are quite difficult to dodge, but not that difficult compared to the ones that are harder for me. If you notice, I mean, it's a bad start. It's a fucking bad start rolling into fucking everything here. But as the fight progresses, you'll see that I'm able to dodge quite comfortably. Another reason why he's hard, he uses quite a variety of attacks if you let him. He'll use fire, spells, and lightning. So, you know, it's not like as if you can put one particular resistance on and feel alright. Another reason why he's hard, 2 stages. So he's got 2 full health bars. The second one, I believe, is more aggressive and his moves are a bit more powerful. But he takes a shit more damage. But, you know, regardless, he's got a lot of life. But for me, why he's up here is the dodging. Again, am I able to dodge? Am I able to heal if I get my dodges wrong and my health goes low? So look at this now. Look how easy that is. Couple of rolls, I can heal comfortably and not get hit again. You'll see with some of the other bosses, I'm fucking healing, but there's an amount of times where I'm fucking healing, but I still get hit. So it's like, it completely nullifies the heal, and you're thinking, fucking hell, where's that window? Where can I fucking heal? But I beat him first time on this attempt. I have died to him a couple of times, I think, in previous ones. So yeah, he's obviously quite hard. This move's what has fucked me up in the past. That does a lot of damage. You get caught by that, and, you know, that was just lucky that my health was up. Otherwise, that would have finished me. But just, you know, it's easy to heal, so make sure your health is up. It's near the end, so you should have almost all your basically Estus and your bone shards available, so that you've got all that healing capacity. Look, there you go. That shows he can be staggered when he's still got a quarter of his life. That's a contributing factor to making it a bit easier. Can't be backstabbed, but yeah, if you stay relatively close to him, he kind of just sticks to fire and lightning. But if you drag back like I did in my spellcaster build, which still worked because I was able to hit him with the soul spheres really easy, he will vary it up a little bit. That's the move. That, see, if he hit me with that, then I'd be finished. That's a good 3/4 of your life. But we've still got 4 Estus flasks yet left. Even with a bad start, should be able to finish him now. And there you go. Yeah, easy to get to, easy to heal, and apart from that one move, hasn't got really anything that's going to take a massive amount of your life left. Quite easy to dodge. So for that reason, he's going to be up here. Number 4, Aldric's Devourer of Gods. Okay, again, I've already died to him on this point, this fella, or girl, I don't know what it is. I've already died to it because you'll see. He's not ultra easy to get to. You need to do quite a lot of running. You need to go through fucking a few knights. The fucking dicks are above the floor. On the ceiling. And the fucking little skeleton guys that throw flame at you. So there's a chance you could lose a flask or two if you don't concentrate. So it's also about, if you keep on dying to him, you'll lose concentration. You'll get angry like I fucking do. And that run will just frustrate you even more. So if you go in there impatient, and it'll affect your fight. So the build up to the boss, you've got to take that into consideration to how fucking difficult it is. The other thing as well, he can fucking one shot you because of this arrow move. That's how I died the first time. If you don't judge it right, he can one shot you. So I suggest, again, get nice and close, try and get close to him. There you go. See, look, this is the move that makes him as high as he is for me. You judge that wrong, that's taking all of your fucking life. I only got hit by it once, look at it, half my life. Be aggressive if you can, bearing in mind all those little fucking dark, little maybug things that are fucking, that he does. And he can do melee attacks, but he's quite long. Try and get his backside, that's probably his most vulnerable point, and just half away. But we got 3 left, because he when you're doing that and he disappears, and then you get caught out by that because the camera, you're not sure where are they, what they're doing. He's got range obviously with spells. It's a fucking good boss. It's a challenging boss. Again, you can leave him quite late, which would probably make him, you know, potentially easier. You've got to take that into consideration. You don't have to beat him. You don't get really anything apart from his soul to make yourself progress. So you could do a lot of it and leave into the end. But yeah, look at that. I've got no flask. Well, I've got 3 flasks less technically with the magic. But really, really close. Came close to killing me a couple of times. Potential to got a one-shotter with that fucking arrow. Yeah, he's a difficult boss without a doubt. 3, Champion Gundor. This is the only playthrough that I've had problems with him. And I think that's because I haven't used a shield. This one I haven't used a shield. And the reason why, I've already died to him, I think it was 4 or 5 times. And the reason for that was, I could not dodge his attacks. I'd like to think, rolling wise, I'm quite good at dodging people's attacks. I've played it long enough to know when you basically need to roll into them rather than rolling out. But his attacks are just, they're all over the place. And that fucking halberd, it goes left, right, backwards. The range is fucking sick, it's so long. So I found in this particular character that I've made, I found this very, very difficult. This fight is jammy if you look at it. I'm quite aggressive, I'm close to him, I'm trying my best. So I'm trying never to roll away from Maggie catching up before, like I said. And but it's just his attacks are just kind of missing. It's like those steps where I was helping me. But that is a difficult boss without a doubt. Shield, I would say, I would suggest using. Not spells, he's too quick and aggressive. His range is too good. But I died to him like 4 or 5 times. So for that reason, again, I couldn't heal very well. He's not easy to get to. It's a long trek to get to him. You have to keep on running past things. The dodging, it's not easy to dodge. As I said, it's not easy to heal. I was doing, the only thing that made him quite easy was the damage I was doing to him. My fucking swords were doing a lot of damage. But he was doing a lot of damage to me. He definitely deserved that spot for me. Number 2, King of the Storm. Before this playthrough, he was always going to be number 1 for me. I've had fucking problems with him. He's a fucking dick. It's all because of this first fight. This fucking Wyvern or Dragon, whatever you want to call it that he's on, it's a dick. I find it so hard to hit when it comes to not having any spells. I find it fucking proper hard to hit. I can't judge it by the camera to if I'm close or not. You know, it's not like as if you can, with the other dragons, you can just go for his legs, which are easy. It's only really the head and neck that are vulnerable to doing any good damage. The fire, look at that, that's half my life. Does good damage to you, whilst this dickhead above is fucking doing a lot of shit to you as well. So it's hard to just get the dodging right, because the camera and everything, I find it difficult. So, to make it easier, I had to change my class, personally, to make this easier. And that was to basically leave him to last and get that Sunlight Spear. Get that Sunlight Spear, change my character so I've got faith in order to use it. And then that first fight is easy. Well, is a lot easier. Because this fight isn't that difficult. So you're probably thinking, well, it sounds like as if, you know, should it be number 2? Well, yeah, it should be number 2 because I've had to basically do this. Like with the Osiris, the dragon one, that was a luxury. I still felt comfortable. I would have beat it even without the lightning and the sunlight to help me. With this, I feel... Nah, I think I would have still been killed a few times in that first stage in particular because of not being able to get my tracking right and fucking hit that stupid dragon. So I felt like, no, I can't be bothered being pissed off with this. I want to make sure I beat him with as much ease as possible. This is the best tactics. Get the Sunlight Spear, throw it in his fucking face, and then let's beat this guy afterwards. Because he's not that difficult. His moves are quite slow. They're not ultra powerful. And... So you can dodge them and without massive repercussions if you do get hit by them. You are able to heal quite easily, so it's got all the contributing factors of this fight being relatively easy. And look, you get to point to even report. So if you've got the Hornet's Ring and you're using a strength weapon, near the end of the fight, this is going to fuck him up. Because you'll get another chance to report now. So yeah, you've got to admit, this second part of the fight is really easy. But the first part of the fight, and because it's combined with 2 health bars, I for me, he's got to be number 2. Because, yeah, just try it. And look at my other playthrough with strength build. I just found the first fight fucking tedious and annoying. Look again, you know, there you go. Very generous giving you those reports. But he's got to be number 2 for me. He really has. Because I've died to him that many times, and I have to do the change. What makes him easy is the fact that, you know, the bonfire really close to him. But fuck him, he's a dick. See you, nerd! Fuck off! Shut up! Number 1, Lurian Elder Prince. Or Princes, it should be, shouldn't it? Oh my god! Yeah, so number one, same as Hrothgar in the Trinocon series, who's fucking hellish good fun to watch, if you notice. Just showing my stats there before we get started. This guy's fucking hard. You know, he was going to be my number 2, but no way. After this playthrough, that... Oh, fuck me. 2 health bars, and if you don't know what you're doing, the fight can seem endless. But it's the fucking... It's the teleporting, and... The teleporting means that he's on your ass, like, all the time, if you're not careful. This move does a fucking shit ton of damage, and it can be quite hard to fucking dodge. It's got quite a large AoE to it if you dodge it quick, which caught me out. As I said, I've already died to him about 5 times. This first fight isn't that difficult, but it's gonna potentially take some of your fucking Estus away from you when the second fight you're gonna need it. what I recommend for this is get yourself, like my strength build, get yourself a heavy shield, a big fuck off shield, and block the majority of it, okay? Because his moves, it's just, you think you're going to dodge alright, but look at this, this second fight. So he's got his little gay boy brother on the back now, doing the spells and stuff like that. You want to try and aim for him if you can, alright? You want to try and get behind and hit him. Because if you don't kill him, he keeps on reviving his fucking bum boy brother. See, look, there you go. I think there's my opportunity to fucking heal. Hits hard. That hits hard as well. Every single move, you feel like you have to Estus for. It's not like you can think, oh, I'll take one or even two hits and I feel like I'll be alright and not Estus. You got to fucking Estus. But because of the teleporting, I'm always, and then the range attacks with the spells, I'm fucking panicking all the time thinking, when is my fucking opportunity to fucking heal? It's just a messy fight. It's a really hard fucking fight. See that then? He varies up the speeds of his attacks. He's got good range because that sword is fucking long. Again, I'm like, oh fuck, here we go. You know, you panic a little bit, especially at this point where I've already lost quite a few times. I'm panicking. It's just, it's relentless, isn't it? You feel like, when's that cool part? Could I buff, you know, could I buff during this fight? Could I fuck? Try and buff in this fight, you're going to be fucking in a lot of shit. So, these are all the contributing factors. Is he easy to get to? He's easy to get to in terms that you don't have to face anything. But the elevator's tedious. When I was getting frustrated, I kept on doing a thing where I wanted to get off the elevator and get back on it to send it back down just in case I died to save time. And because of my frustration, I just wouldn't be able to get off the elevator in time. And I'd just be getting more pissed off. Right, this is where these type of weapons is fucking brilliant. As soon as he's trying to revive his mate there, so if you're cautious and you're far away and you let him do it, his brother's going to come back with full health. He won't have the health, but he'll come back with full health. So that's why it was great to fucking smash him while he's trying to do that with my swords, with my quick swords, get the damage and beat him. But definitely for me, the fucking hardest boss. Hard to heal, pain in the ass to get to, powerful hits. So that's all the bosses from my point of view. Brilliant, nice one, great game.